A man guilty for hiring hitmen to kill his wife is trying to get off of death row. Mark Sievers faces the death penalty for his wife's murder, and attorneys want a resentencing. A judge ordered all parties to meet again in August. This push centers around that new change to the death penalty law where jurors do not have to be unanimous for the death penalty. Wheat News anchor Annette Montgomery joins us now live from the Lee County Courthouse. Annette, without needing a unanimous decision, is this changing how jurors think?
Russ and Lois, experts say yes. A certified behavior analyst with 55 years of experience tells me now that jurors know they can fall back on the 11 other people sitting on the jury with them, they feel less inclined to sentence someone to death and more likely to vote with their conscience.
Juror 87 from the Wade Wilson trial can tell you.
You kind of have this really big sense of responsibility, putting, you know, any of your personal feelings aside and just being able to focus on facts.
Sitting on a jury where the death penalty is on the table is no easy task.
There were things thrown out like, do we want to have the death penalty because he's just going to get appeal after appeal and his family's already been through enough.
But a change in the Florida law now only requiring 8 out of 12 jurors to recommend the death penalty instead of all 12 may lead to a change in jurors' behavior. It's what Dr. Dwayne Daubert, a certified behavior analyst with 55 years of experience, believes.
Do you think there's a change in a juror's psyche now, knowing that they can say no? Do you think we might start seeing more cases where it's not a unanimous decision for death, even if it's a crucial or brutal case where people will be more inclined to say no?
Yes, I do believe that's a possibility. I think what's going to happen, and this is obviously conjecture on my part, but I've been in the business for 55 years, that we're going to see that in these Florida cases that they're going to concentrate on aggravating circumstances.
We've already seen the impact of the law locally. Before the change in law in 2019, Mark Sievers hired two men to kill his wife, and the jury unanimously sentenced him to death. But take a look at these three other local cases after the law was changed. None of them had a unanimous vote for death, even though they were convicted of killing multiple people.
So I think the jurors will feel that it's okay for them to say no. It's on the whole panel jury. And so they can say no. And even if that person is sentenced to death, that they say, well, on my conscience, it's okay. Because someone else, I didn't vote for it.
Another change Dr. Daubert says we can expect to see as a result of a change in the law is a lot more people on death row. He says that increase may result in the Supreme Court getting involved and reversing this decision. Another change he says we can expect to see is how prosecutors and defense attorneys now change their strategy when picking potential jurors. Live in Fort Myers, Annette Montgomery, Wink News.